Welcome to Working the Web to Win. I'm your host, Carl Weiss. With me is Hector the Connector Cisneros, and our special guest today is Julie Morton with Value Hound. How are you folks doing today?
Great. Good.
Great.
Hey, everybody.
Hello.
As you know, we've been concentrating on the hot button topics that are affecting the web, and one of the hottest buttons would have to be the online coupon phenomenon, which has been gathering momentum for the past couple of years. Before we get to talking to Julie about her site, what I'd like to do is focus on, obviously, the big dogs, Groupon, who went public not too long ago, and Living Social and some of those clones, because the thing is that from what I've been reading online, there's a, you know, a good part of it and a bad part of it. Obviously, people, consumers, like the idea of getting discounts. But for the business people, unless you read the fine print, sometimes we've seen business people that have actually been hurt by some of these online couponing sites because of the fact that they weren't expecting to have such a big return.
Right. Well, I've actually seen some retailers tell me horror stories where they've lost literally $100,000. And that's a huge amount of money. As a matter of fact, I've even seen stories where people have gone away because they did this big deal and then they couldn't meet the demand. Plus, they were doing the demand at 25% loss on cost, and you know. So, if you look on the internet, you'll see lots of articles talking about these kinds of horror stories.
Oh yeah,
they're pretty common.
I googled it this morning. Just did a Google search on Groupon complaints, and the number was over 1 million.
Right. Wow.
But you know, a lot of times I think these things almost feed on themselves because again, unless you know what you're getting yourself into, you can, you know, just like with any type of advertising contract, you can get hurt because, like you were talking about, 25%. Now, you might offer 25% to a consumer, but with the Google model, the Living Social model, as a business that takes advantage of that, you also have to pay an additional 25% in matching fund to the coupon purveyor. So you're actually, in essence, taking 50% off of the top.
Well, yeah. Well, most of them actually do 50% off the top, and then Groupon takes 25% of that. So, and that's already dipping in way below your profit, so you're at a loss. You're a loss leader.
Yeah, and if all of a sudden that you get 1,000 people to take you up on that offer, all of a sudden you can be in a really bad situation.
That's exactly how that one company lost $100,000. Yeah. They were making cupcakes of all things.
Oh, really?
$100,000 on cupcakes.
Ouch.
That's a lot of cupcakes.
A lot of icing.
Yeah. There's obviously somebody that's losing $100,000. He's not going to be able to put his best foot forward and give you the absolute best product that he can. So then that'll result in a complaint on the purveyor as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know it's not totally all bad. I mean, we, you know, it's really easy to focus in on the negative stuff. I read some things earlier on the web today where it talked something like $3.7 billion were saved. The dollars were saved in the U.S. this year.
Yeah.
And the number of coupons, this was a record year for a number of coupons distributed by companies.
Yeah.
So it's the biggest year ever. So the economy is really making this rage on, and people are using coupons.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, think about it. You got TV shows, extreme couponing now.
Right.
Just on this subject. Yeah. And you know, TV shows like American Restoration, anything that saves money today is a big hit.
Absolutely, because of the economy.
Right. The economy's in the dirt, and people want to save money.
But let's talk about the economics, because, you know, here's the problem. Even for the people that are running these sites, it has not been a successful model. In fact, Groupon literally loses money every day. Even though they're, you know, publicly traded, it actually costs them more money to generate new clients than they're actually making. And that's because of the fact that there are so many sites now in this game. You know, you go back to like 2010, and Groupon was spending just under $8 to acquire a customer. But we just roll over 12 months. In other words, by 2011, that figure had jumped to $23.46, almost, you know, a fourfold increase in the cost per acquisition, and that's just on the marketing side. That doesn't take into the fact that they're also have a huge sales force. I mean, what is it? There were close to 1,000 salespeople in 2011, so I'm sure they're over that by now. I mean, those are a lot of mouths to feed,
yes.
And that all starts to take a bite out of, you know, the bottom line.
I mean, there's no doubt that businesses who are trying to do this are just trying to generate people. Hopefully they'll get some loyal customers.
Right.
But statistics show also that generally if it's a heavy discounted deal, they're not going to be so loyal. I mean, they're going there for the money and people are trying to save money. So,
well, a lot of times though, that's the other side of the coin too, because for instance, one of the things that a lot of businesses do not do, because somebody came in and I was saying, well, here, I'm going to give you a discount on my project, my widget, whatever. Mm-hmm. Well, when you came in, I'd make sure I got a little quid pro quo, particularly if I'm giving the thing away at a loss. So it's like, hey, how would you like to join, you know, give me your email address? A lot of these people aren't even keeping track of the people that are coming in the door. And a lot of the coupon sites are not going to automatically just share that information
with you.
So
when sharing the information.
But the point is, when somebody comes in, you've got the ability to ask for that or incentivize it. You know, put your, you know, the old goldfish bowl, put your,
lunch,
yeah, put your business card in the bowl and win a free, you know, gimme.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, you know, a lot of times, like I said, it's the business themselves that really aren't prepared to capitalize on this kind of an offer.
Yeah. And it's a shame, too, because if you look at the history of it, you go back 10 years, couponing was always big, even during the first Gulf War and all that kind of stuff. But today, the internet has really made it explode. There are literally hundreds of thousands of sites to deal with couponing. Mm-hmm. If you do a search on any one of these subjects, I just did couponing, and I brought 885 million hits.
That's insane.
Just on couponing. and if you just type in discount deals, it doesn't matter what you type in, it's going to be in the hundreds of millions of hits.
Sure.
So it's a really huge thing. And part of that is because 10 years ago, the internet was nowhere near as big as it is today. It's literally tenfold bigger than it was 10 years ago.
I think the number's even bigger than that. Because like I said, I'm just looking at the statistics that I picked up when I was doing a little research online. And they pointed out that in 2011, the industry, the daily deal industry, mm-hmm. went from 530 players, and then they ended up losing 170 players because of the fact that they couldn't keep up with it. Because, you know, as you have more people getting into the game, obviously one of the big ways of promoting this thing is Google. And if you're in a pay-per-click scenario, well, you know, it's an auction.
Right.
So the more players you have, the higher the price goes up. And, you know, the big guys, they can sweat the differential, but a lot of the small players, you know, the guys that are just getting into the business, they quickly rolled over because they can't afford the VIG. It's like going to Vegas, you know, and you walk from playing with your buddies at home for nickel and dime, and all of a sudden, you know, you're in Binion's and it's the World Series of Poker. It's a whole different ballgame.
Right, it's a whole different ballgame. As a matter of fact, I think that's really what's made the local industry sort of pop up too, because a lot of these things, a lot of the vendors are not happy with the current scenario. So you see a lot of new local vendors trying to take over. I believe that's why we have Julie here, our expert.
Yeah, one of the reasons that Julie's here, you know, is because she has a business called ValueHound.com that is in this game, but she's actually got a slightly different product. Not everybody has been, you know, exactly 100% happy with the current model that's being offered out there, and a lot of these businesses are literally a carbon copy of Groupon. So they've got a different name, but it's basically the same process.
Right. Exactly.
Living Social is essentially a Groupon of a different name.
Right. So what I always like to say about business is one person's problem is another person's opportunity. Right. And what Julie has done is she's come up with something that offers along the lines of the same type of opportunity to get a discount for the consumer, but she has changed the matrix a little bit. She's not putting another clone out there. So, Julie, just tell our listeners just a little bit about what makes ValueHound a different breed of cat.
We are different in a couple different facets. Number one, we're not coupons. I clip coupons for groceries. My partner, Tishel, does not. She hates to clip coupons. She usually ends up handing the coupons back to the person who's standing in line behind her because we just don't have time. We're both working mothers. She has two children. I have three children. We're just very, very busy. So we're different in the fact that we're not a coupon company. Mm-hmm. We're mistaken for that. We're actually giving ongoing discounts. So every time somebody goes into a participating business, they're going to get that discount every time they shop there. We're also not taking away from the bottom line of the business as well. We're not taking away from the profits. We're actually helping them because we're not charging the business.
Well, I know that there are several new sites. I know Money Pages and Papermint have put together their own sites. There's a site called Deal Skillet that's new here in Jacksonville. I've never tried them, so I don't know whether they're any good or not. I know that you want to look at probably ValueHound online. Some of the TV shows, I think it's called Value Pig. They have their own deal. And I think one of the newspapers you were talking about.
It's called Group Pig is what it is. Okay. There's about 8 different daily deals. And the great thing about ValueHound, it's not a daily deal. It actually, technically it's a daily deal every single time you shop there.
Well, it's like a discount club.
It's like a discount club. Right. Exactly, exactly. You get a card. You're going to get your name and expiration date on it, and you just flash your card. And we have about 400 participating businesses, restaurants, dry cleaners, nail salons, hair salons, anything you can think of under the sun, we pretty much have, anywhere from tax preparation, anything.
But let me just clarify a little bit. When you walk into a retailer that's that's a Value Hound member, all right, you give them your card. Here's my card.
Yes.
Okay. And then, I mean, are they offering certain items, or they offer a discount across the board? How does your model
90% of our participating businesses offer discount across the board. Restaurants, for example, you're going to get a minimum of 10% off the participating restaurants. You can really save beyond the cost of membership just in one meal out with some friends, if you know, if you're generous enough to pay the bill.
Right.
it's you just simply, there are some retailers that say, you know, maybe only 10% off or half off of hats or half off of scarves or a certain product that they, you know, really, really want to get their discount on. But 90% of them or more, really, I should say, are giving an across-the-board discount.
Okay, so let's say I walk in, you know, and I hand my card, and this is one of your, you know, your members, as far as the retail establishment is concerned. I mean, is this something where I have to go to the website to find out what they're offering beforehand, or when I walk in? I mean, how does it normally work?
Yeah, our website has a discount directory.
Okay.
And
looking at right now, by the way.
It's really, really cool. You can actually sort it by the area town here in Jacksonville, or you can sort it by type, or both. So if I want to find, if I live in the Southside area, I click restaurants in Southside, and it, voila, it pops up all the restaurants that are in that area.
And then it'll tell you what they're offering?
Exactly.
Oh, good.
Yeah, whether it's 10%, 20%, so kids eat free. Mm-hmm. We have restaurants that actually offer strictly just for our members, kids eat free. So that's actually a big savings alone in that, especially if you have more than one kid.
So this way you do a quick scan, and then you can see who's got the best offer.
Exactly, exactly. And that's kind of where the loyalty comes in for the business side as well. Because, like I mentioned earlier, we don't charge the business to participate with us. So we say, you know, you don't have to get the farm away to get the business, like those Groupon, those daily deals do.
Yeah, everybody shares. The consumer pays a little bit. The merchant's going to give a little bit. Everybody wins.
Exactly.
Well, I know if you look on here, there's all kinds. You got Jiffy Lube. You got lots of restaurants. You got mobile cell phone dealers.
Metro PC, you have
lots of stuff that's on here. Just tons and tons of places. Matter of fact, I've been scrolling here for a little while, and it's still,
the list goes on and on and on, and we're acquiring. I mean, I think I'm adding probably anywhere from 50 to 70 businesses a week that want to participate with us, because they do see the difference with us versus those daily deals. Sure. We're not cutting into their profits. We're not cutting into their bottom line.
Right. No, I like it. It's like I said, evolution is important.
Plus 25 to 75% of
right.
People really can't, you know, deal with
that. Do that too often.
Yeah, I mean, I know myself. I mean, I do. I like those daily deals. I'm always looking for deals. Mm-hmm. So is everybody else. Mm-hmm. But I honestly have to say, I have actually probably purchased about 4 or 5 of those deals and never used them.
Well, you know, the whole business has spawned because of that,
right? As a matter of fact, we were talking about this earlier, a whole brand new add-on industry, the reselling Groupon, coupons, and living social.
There's actually sites out there you can go and you can repost your daily deal purchases, and then they're made.
This is America.
God bless America.
Next week, our guest will be Jen DeVore, and she is going to be announcing the Small Business Super Makeover Contest. Again, people in Jacksonville will have a chance to take advantage of. Now, there's, you know, they only work with certain businesses because it's a makeover. I mean, literally, they're going to come in and make over your
space. It's a contest, and they have to win that spot.
That's right.
It's pretty exciting when you think about it.
So we'll be talking about that. Plus, we're also going to talk about what it will take to give your website a makeover. Because I know a lot of people that are out there are still using old-school technology to promote their business online.
I'd say about 90% of the people are still doing it like if they were in the 2000s or something.
You know, the thing is that today it's a whole different ballgame, and that's what we're going to clue into what you need to do.